Okay, I'm fixing to interview Mike Gaynor, a legend Hall of Fame member, a teammate of mine for like 35 years, one of the best hitters on the team. He's just recently come out of retirement. Let's go to Mike Gaynor. Okay, Mike, I just told everybody who you were, big slugger, left-handed. Tell us a little bit about, you graduated FSU, right?
Yep.
Center fielder or something?
5 years.
5 years, you were center fielder, right?
Yeah, left fielder.
Left fielder, okay. Okay, well, let's get to softball, man. We played together, what, since 50s, right? 27 years, I guess.
Yep, I came on in 2000 in Las Vegas, and I have always had a saying, you know, I finally made Ed Rose's team. Yeah, I made Ed's team, but can you stay with Ed's team? That's, you know, that's always a good thing if you could stay with Ed's team.
Yeah, well, you were a great player, our great player, our leadoff hitter. Mike gets on the way that Mike goes, we go. Well, Mike, we're here to ask you, what's your secret of hitting, big guy? I know you're a great baseball hitter, a great softball hitter, leadoff hitter. So tell us.
A couple of things that work for me. Everyone's different. Everyone has a different body shape. Everyone has different length of arms. But what I like, what helps me, is my grip, which aligns
you
these
stand your grip.
Buckles up.
Yeah, okay, yeah.
Yeah, some people do it like this.
Yeah.
And you can't, it's not good for flipping the bat or your wrist.
Mm-hmm.
If you line your knuckles up, it's a lot easier to break your wrist and flick on the ball. It also gives you a lot more bat control, in my opinion. Another good thing is I see a lot of guys that get at the plate and they'll have the bat, here comes the pitch, and they do this. Dip. You can't do that. You have to keep still, keep your head still, just like in golf.
Yeah.
If you move your head forward, you're going to hit the ball on the handle.
So
try to keep your head, you know, where still, and then come into the ball. So
watch the bat hit the ball.
You don't have to watch the bat hit the ball. If you have good control. The other thing. And last but not least is hit the ball where it's pitched. Don't try to do something with the ball that is not conducive to hitting a good, getting the bat on the ball and hitting it hard.
So the number one thing that you do when you get in the box is?
I take a big breath and I try to imagine, have an imaginary pitch that's floating down that's going to be a strike. So as soon as I get that pitch, I'm swinging. I'm going after it. Because in my opinion, you only get one good pitch per at bat. And if it's your pitch, go get it.
Well, that's for sure. So the key to being a good hitter mentally is what?
Mentally is, again, you've got to have good thoughts. If you think you're gonna make an out, you're worried about making it out.
So a positive attitude, right?
Oh, without a doubt.
And don't overthink in the box.
Yeah. If I don't have a good attitude, I don't want to get in the box. And the fact that I've got good teammates that support me, and you know, you don't want to let your teammates down. So, you know,
motivate
you. Got to mentally focus. If you don't, especially in our division, you're not going to hit 500. Because people are going to make plays on you.
Absolutely. Hey, you know, I have a saying, you got to have amnesia. Actually, it wasn't mine. It was one of my son's. But what do you think about that? You know what I mean by that, having amnesia?
Yeah. If you have a bad at bat, you can't change it. Let it go. Just forget you did that. Hopefully learn from it. And I've always said that regardless of how good you've done, your halo can become a noose if you're not careful.
Yeah, one day you're on the top of the world, and next at bat you're
it's double play, baby.
Yeah, well, let's give him hell today.
Hey, Ed, always good to see you and talk to you.
Same to you, brother. Pull my windows down and cruise down about